This is why this place is great. All right, now we're up to, yeah. So it's funny because I'm one of those people who's from here. And when I saw James's name and I was on Cole Medicine, and I'm like, Albuquerque, like barbecue, but it's not. But
thank you. My name is Jim.
See?
Our project we're working on, it's called Envision Raleigh. It's about developing a 3D platform, immersive platform over the web, to share.
Step up to the mic.
To share planning and visioning with citizens. And so I'm going to tell you a little bit about the project and why we think it's a good idea and kind of what our vision is. So a few months ago, we partnered with NC State to put together a proposal for a Charles Benting grant with Next Century Cities to develop this platform. We were selected at one of three cities along with Louisville and Austin. So over the next 9 months, we're going to be developing this platform in conjunction with NC State. So why do we think it's a good idea? So I'm a math guy. Right? So I think that maps can be useful and valuable in almost anything we do. They can be, you know, if the AV system doesn't work, I think maps can be brought to bear to solve those particular problems. If this joke doesn't resonate with you, you should look on YouTube for how often and how about, because it's really a pretty funny joke. But anyways, so maps are great for showing vision, complex information in a very succinct and easy way. Again, I'm a map guy, so I think that maps can be used almost anywhere. In the city, we have experience with using maps and digital platforms as a way to engage citizens around kind of complex and crazy processes. So recently, we went through a rezoning process where we rezoned almost 30% of our property, and we were able to develop a platform where citizens could see what their current zoning is, what their future zoning is going to be, provide comments to the city that were visible through to anyone with an internet browser, and then the city was able to respond to that comment, and that response was also available to the citizens of Raleigh. So another reason that we think this is a good platform is, you know, in an ad hoc way, we know that 3D is an engaging platform around urban design, planning, zoning, etc. So I recently went to the SparkCon conference last week, and in one of the intersections, they had this really interesting, immersive, engaging platform where citizens could kind of go and talk about location in a 3D way. So the project is about data and technology, right? So we need to develop data, we need to develop technology, and that's where the City of Raleigh and NC State can potentially partner. So on the data side, the state in 2015 did a massive LIDAR flight where they capture high-resolution LIDAR data, and we'll get into what that is. But really, what you can do is you can extract features, whether it be buildings or vegetation, to potentially develop a 3D scene that you can then provide through the web. So what's some of the things we can do with this platform? So we can start to look at things around urban design. So shadows are a big thing around urban design. They affect how we use and think about open space. They how we think about buildings and HVAC systems and how we design them. The goal of the next three slides is for you guys to say, oh, no, so if you could. Thank you. So we can also do analytics and reporting. So this is looking at shadows across the year. So this is current conditions in just south of downtown Raleigh, and what the shadow impact is. Red means it doesn't have a lot of shadow impact. Blue indicates it does. That's really interesting, but what if we added a scenario of a downtown campus? If we were to kind of consolidate the civic campus and put it in downtown Raleigh, that would be pretty interesting, but what would be the effect of those shadows? So we can also do things like modeling, you know, 3D modeling for flood inundation and potentially identify those things that are at-risk buildings. And the last use case, which I think is the most interesting, is around zoning. So I talked about a massive rezoning effort we did over the last couple of years. you know, in downtown Raleigh, wouldn't it be great to be able to see what the zoning envelope of the current zoning conditions would be? So what we're actually developing now with NC State is this platform where you could potentially look at a piece of zone and actually change its zoning designation and see what that might affect. So, you know, this is just a mock-up, an example that, hey, what if I took this particular zone, zoning district on East Cabrera Street, and I actually was able to change its zoning value and see how it affected interesting things like gross floor area, tax, total tax assessment, retail space, office space, etc. That's it. Thank you.